We're at the International Builder Show. This is the new American remodel home. I love the offset. Check out this ceiling with the offset lighting. Every room, it's like a little sanctuary.
People tend to be overstimulated by all of the products that are available on the market. We wanted to create a very modern but organic feeling home.
This is just amazing. This is unbelievable. Now look at this. Imagine this is your guest bathroom. Oh, wait, look. You walk up to the toilet and it automatically opens. This is pretty awesome. We're seeing a lot of Kohler. I don't know what the faucet brand is. Wow. I love the offset. Check out this ceiling with the offset lighting. The natural stone. Check out the minimalist ceiling up in here. Oh, so this has got to be a privacy shade. That's how it goes, man. And then look at this. We're going to check out the bar. Okay, something really interesting. A lot of times these sliding glass doors have like a ledge. This has zero trip hazard there, which I think is awesome. And this is actually a 5-door slider. We're going to open it up all the way. And it's actually a huge door, but it's super easy. Like, I'm doing this just with my fingers. This is some serious engineering.
Elma Gardner.
Elma Gardner, and then you're the designer.
Designer of the house, yes. I worked with Studio G Architecture and Luxus Design Build on the house for over a year.
Beautiful. And by the way, congratulations. This is a big deal. There's a lot of feedback that's just beautiful. Now, you're in charge of, is it the colors and styles or the furniture or the merchandising or what specifically?
Actually, all of those things. So I was introduced to the project when it was still on paper. And worked with Michael on the furniture layouts, all of the material selections. We collaborated on all of the interior selections, and I even collaborated on some of the exterior, although most of that was Michael already had in his mind exactly how he wanted it to look. But then everything that you see in the home, the commissioned art, all of the, you know, the bedding, the furniture, right down to the, you know, plates and cups and accessories.
How much of it is you saying, okay, this is what's hot, I'm going to infuse it, or do you say, hey, what do you want me to do, and then you do it? Which way?
Neither. It all comes from the architectural integrity of the home. Because I worked with Michael on the finishes, I knew the feel that he wanted. And we wanted to create a very modern but organic feeling home. And so the inspiration came from outside. It came from the railroad ties. It came from the texture of the materials that he used on the exterior. So then I built on that by choosing fabrics that are textured, by choosing tile that is textured, multi-layered neutral colors with just pops of sort of brighter colors that come from nature. And that's why you see the citrusy green and yellow in the home.
It's very clean and almost not minimalist, but it seems like that clean, you know, not a lot of clutter. Is that something that you see trending right now?
I do. I think it's a design aesthetic that we particularly like. We strive to create that feeling while still keeping a warmth to the home. And that's kind of a very, hard line or difficult line to walk to blend those two things. Because I think we're moving away from the very stark contemporary that we've been looking at, the very contrasting kind of contemporary that we've been looking at the last couple of years. And I think this is the progression, this sort of very modern feeling that's not desert modern, but has this organic kind of warmth to it.
One quick question. What's the biggest mistake you see right now with designer? Like if you go to a model home and you're like, oh God, I cringe when I see that.
The thing is that people tend to be overstimulated by all of the products that are available on the market. And there is a tendency to pull too many things into play in the overall design scheme. And then, you know, it's hard to focus. It's hard to know, you know, where to look. Each individual, you know, element can be wonderful, but it becomes a little overstimulating. And I think in life, we're overstimulated as far as technology goes. And I think we want to create something in our homes that's quieter, that has less of that feeling that we never know where to let our eyes rest.
What resources do you recommend, or how do we follow you and what you're doing? Do you do writing, do blogs? Do you have any way that we could connect, a website?
I have a website. I also have a business Facebook page that I connect on. I need to get better at doing things like Twitter.
No, you're doing great. You're at the tip of the spear here, leading everybody.
You know, keeping up with my Facebook page is you know, enough work. I work by myself. I have a small showroom, so I do everything. So just keeping up with that keeps me more than busy.
But what resources do you tap into, or is it a natural gift? I mean, how did you get where? Because you're obviously leading. You're doing some big things on a national scale. What was your inspiration?
I think my inspiration in general has been from travel, from actually keeping my eyes open. You know, art is very, very influential in my life. And I have to tell you the truth, Michael Gardner, he's my son, and, you know, he inspires me every day. He does the most incredible work, and he will just say something that sends me down a research path in a completely different way. And so we just seem to be able to collaborate pretty well together.
Well, congratulations to you. Congratulations to your son. What an amazing, I mean, this feels like just everything you described it is a very warm feel, but it's also, you know that it's just very well done.
Oh, well, thank you. That's very, very nice of you to say so. And I'm very proud of the house. Proud of my son, and it's been an absolutely wonderful project to work with.
So what's the best website to connect with you?
I am bydesign-studio.com, and Facebook page is just By Design Studio Inc., and that will find me, no problem.
Check her out. This home is amazing. What's your favorite part of the home?
Oh, that's a terribly unfair question. My favorite room is probably the master bathroom, you know. And my favorite element in the house would be the commissioned artwork from Tim Cantor. He's a surrealist out of San Diego, and he does the album covers for the Imagine Dragons. And we connected with him some time ago, and he and his lovely wife, Amy, I worked with to select the art that's on the walls. And so I love it.
You mentioned you travel. What's your favorite place to travel to? Europe? Do you go to South America? What do you like?
Well, I've been spoiled. I've been lucky enough to travel quite a lot. I love Spain. As far as, you know, the art world's concerned and architecture's concerned, Spain is absolutely unbelievable. I mean, Barcelona and Gaudi, and I mean,
do you speak Spanish? Is that
not one word, and I should, you know, but I get around and seems to work just fine. And then on the other spectrum, I was lucky enough to travel in South Africa, and that was very inspirational in a completely different way.
Well, you speak the language of the heart, which is design, and you're connecting with people. You brought a lot of people here today. I'm very proud to have you on the program. Thank you.
Thank you so much. It's been a delight. It was lovely meeting you.
And we're here at the Remodelers, a new American remodeled home.